talk about something which I think we need to have a sense of how we manage our rivers. Okay, how we manage our rivers. This is important because we only think that it is the chemicals. It is chemicals that are polluting our rivers. It's heavy metals that are polluting our rivers. I must point out to you that our rivers are a waste basket. It's a rubbish bin. It is actually a rubbish bin. So you have chemical waste, you have plastic waste, you have electronic waste, you have husbandry waste, and you know, you have sewerage pollution in the river. So you use the river as a dumping ground. Now there are problems attached to this because one, that same polluted water is what that goes to feed chickens, feed your cows, feed your goat, drink your, for drinking purposes, but also for agriculture, including rice production, including rice production. So it's polluted water that is actually going to for the water that you need for your sayuran and also for your vegetables consumption and so on. So what are you eating? And on top of that, you have a polluted water and you have fish in the water, you have crabs in the water, you have prawns in the water, you have all kinds of sea life, seafood in the water, which you are also consuming. So there must come a point where you have to say, this has to stop. It is just not chemicals. It's not just heavy metals. It is, we perceive, our businesses perceive, our households perceive, the rubbish, the rivers are dumping grounds. This has to change though. And I, and when we were in Spain, we had a two-day seminar. We had a two-day seminar on this issue. And we came out with some recommendations. I want to share the recommendations. And I want the Slovak government, including the Minister of Water, right now, Minister of Water and Environment, to really give this a hearing though. It's very simple. At this time, next to a river, you have a 50 meters buffer. My suggestion and the suggestions of a lot of people is extend that buffer by another 100 meters or more, depending on the requirement. Together with the buffer and the river, declare the entire area a national security area, which means now you cannot, nobody can go into that area. That means if the river in the center and the buffer is 150 meters on both sides, it is a security area. Nobody has access to that river anymore. Nobody will have access to the river anymore. So you can use your drones, you can use your enforcement people, you can use all kinds of authorities to go and monitor the place. And therefore, what we need is a river protection authority. This is something that we need, a river protection authority. It has come to that. And if you have factories along the 150 or 200 meters buffer, it's very simple. If they are legitimate, you transfer them to an industrial area. If they are illegal, then the government decides, the state government decides whether you want it to legalize it or you want to demolish it. Make a decision, but do it as soon as possible. Because if you do not do this and you just depend on drones and enforcement and so on, you will never solve this problem. So a very something that has to be thought is declare the rivers and the buffers around the rivers as national security area and bring national enforcement into the area so that water in the rivers can be protected. Because if there's no water in the river or if the carrying capacity drops and the more pollution in the river, you and I are going to suffer and this is going to be fatal though. Thank you very much and thanks for your attention.